Good morning once again. Today we are going to start with the second chapter, Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. With the very hope that you have finished with the first chapter. The chapter Lost Spring, there is a metaphor in the title itself. This chapter is full of metaphor, irony, and other such literary devices. The author of this chapter is Anees Jung, who is an Indian women writer, a journalist, a columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad. In this story, the author unveils the utter destitution of the ragpickers of Sumapuri and the utter destitution of the bangle makers of Firozabad. This story also tells about the grinding poverty and the traditions that compel the children to live a life full of exploitation. There are three people who have been described by Anees Jung. The first person is Sahib, whose full name is Sahib-e-Alam. And Sahib-e-Alam means Lord of Universe. Now there is a big irony in the name and the meaning of this person, because Sahib-e-Alam means the Lord of Universe, and if we see Sahib is a mere rag picker. The second person who is talked about in this chapter is Mukesh. He is so convicted, he is so determined. He doesn't take the life as it is, which has been given by his parents to him. He wants to do something else. And that is why he has been shown very convicted in this chapter. And Anees Jung notices him as well. The third person is Savita. Savita, the girl. So we'll take these three people one by one, chapter wise. Sahib, son of a migrant family from Dhaka, is a rag picker who lives in Simapuri at the periphery of Delhi. Periphery of Delhi? At the edges of the Delhi. And goes about barefoot, rummaging around in the heaps of garbage to earn his livelihood. You know, children, these people have come from Dhaka because there was some natural calamity, and this calamity made them in such a condition, it brought them to such a condition that they were not able to fill their tummies there. So they had to shift from that place. So from that place, Dhaka, Bangladesh, they came to Delhi. Now, for these children like Sahib, heap of garbage is like a gold mine. Thousands of children live with their families in Simapuri. They live in slum with not even the basic amenities such as water, sanitation available to them. These families are living in utter poverty. The children have nothing else to do except rag picking, through which they earn something to eat at least. Garbage to the children is a means of survival, but for these children, it is a magical wonder. In order to earn better, Sahib starts working at tea stall. There are incidences in the chapter where Anees Jung promises to Sahib about a school, that whether he would want to go to a school or not. And he is so desperate about it that whenever he meets and sees Anees Jung, he asks the question that, is your school ready? And to such question, Anees Jung was so embarrassed. And she has very well quoted that, promises like mine are like blots and blemishes in the life of such people. So because Saheb wanted to do something else, something magical, something wonderful. So he starts working at a tea stall where he is paid rupees 800 per month. But it seems he, after this, has lost his carefreeness. He works for someone else and is no longer his own master. Because when he was picking the rags, he was the master of his own. There was nobody to guide. But when he is working in a tea stall, see that he was working under somebody. So he was no longer his own master. This loss of identity weighs heavily on his tender shoulders. The second person Anees Jung talks about is Mukesh. She talks about Mukesh, who wants to be his own master. He is a boy from Firozabad's glass making bangle industry and has a family tradition. He has always worked in a glass bangle factory. Here the children work in close proximity of furnaces and in such high temperatures that they are exposed to various health hazards, even losing their eyesight. And it is talked that these children are so adjusted in darkness that when they come out of this darkness for some time, they feel uncomfortable. Means their eyes are adjusted to the darkness because they work in small dingy cells. This is such a big irony. Now Mukesh's family, like other families of Firozabad, are victims of poverty. His father is blind and then live in small half-constructed house. These people of Firozabad are exploited by sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, the bureaucrats, the politicians, means all positioned people. But Mukesh is different and confident. He wants to be a motor mechanic. And to be a motor mechanic, he's ready for like anything. He goes by walk to learn about. He's ready for that. In the last in this story, the author brings about a depravity of child labor. Savita, the girl who is working with the old lady, does not even know the meaning of the bangles, but she's doing because she has nothing else to do. She has seen the elders doing the same. The elders who has, like they say that they have not even got meal twice a day, spending the whole time making the bangles. In fact, the childhood is considered as spring of human life and should like it should be full of enjoy, pleasure and play. But ironically, millions of children like Saheb and Mukesh have lost their spring. That is the childhood by getting engaged in making a living. So we could see that the title is so apt, Lost Spring. The spring of the children which is completely lost by earning for their livelihood, earning for the family, earning for themselves. And in this melee, they forget what the childhood is for. This is the basic chapter. Thank you, children.